We come closer, we'll get the on the power button, we've got on and off. We'll get the sweep button, which moves the machine from side to side. We'll get the feed button, that slow, we're at 10, that'll be 10 seconds, 8 seconds, 4 seconds, 2 seconds. The speed button is the miles per hour the ball's coming out, so 35 mile an hour, 45 mile an hour, 55, 65. We want to have about 45, 65 is obviously too fast. We'll get the reset button here. If obviously something goes wrong with the machine, we can press that down, that resets the machine.
Right, so this knob here changes the angle of which the ball comes out of the machine. If it's up at 40, as you see, up at the top, it goes and it's more of a lob, and if you move it down, it'll become more of a ground stroke ball, and that's about it. All you need to do is twist it, pull it out, and that's you.
First of all, when you're using it, it has to be on court 1 or court 4, and secondly, on the machine, you have 30 seconds to get round to the other side of the court before the ball start coming out.
Yep, most importantly, the rain comes on, the ball machine is recovered, turned off, and off the court as soon as possible.
Basically, balls can't go back in the machine.
Yep. Last of all, there's a port here for charging the battery. So as soon as the ball machine has been used, take it off court, in the shutters there'll be an adapter for it. Put on charge for about 30-40 minutes for the next person to use.